Today, I will be explaining the practicing the occupational health and safety procedures. Managing safety and health is an integral part of managing a business. Businesses need to do a risk assessment to find out about the hazards and risks in their workplace and put measures in place to effectively control them to ensure these hazards and risks cannot cause harm to workers. The Occupational Safety and Health Policy defines the goal for the occupational health and safety work in the workplace and for activities that promote the working capacity of the staff. The policy also describes occupational health and safety responsibilities and the way of organizing the cooperation measures. The preparation of the Occupational Safety and Health Policy is based on the Occupational Safety and Health Act. The policy is employer specific and applies to all employers. The contents of Occupational Safety and Health Policy. Occupational health and safety responsibilities and obligations in accordance with the work duties and powers. Who are the employers and who are the employees' representatives? Organization of occupational health and safety cooperation and cooperation personnel, occupational safety manager, occupational safety representative and deputy representatives, occupational safety ombudsman and other cooperation personnel, occupational safety partners, organization of the occupational safety committee. Occupational healthcare, method of organization and contents, contact person, workplace safety instructions, instruction for specific situations, example, working alone, threat of violence, early support, first aid. Description of the work environment and development needs. Identification of work hazards and risk assessment, work space, working conditions, activities. Issue to monitor related to working conditions, sick leave, accidents at work, incident reporting, work capacity evaluation, monitoring the amount of work strain, work atmosphere. Occupational health and safety work in the workplace, work orientation and guidance, procurement, training and communication, development activity and situations of change. Monitoring and maintenance of the policy, persons responsible. These 10 rules for workplace safety can be applied in nearly every workplace. Number 1, preventing workplace incidents is everyone's job and your personal safety is your responsibility. Number 2, dress appropriately from clothing to footwear. Number 3, keep work areas neat and tidy. Number 4, follow the rules. Number 5, report workplace accidents or safety incidents. Number 6, know and follow emergency procedures. Number 7, lift, bend, and stretch with care to avoid injury. Number 8, don't operate tools or machinery that you haven't been trained for. Number 9, avoid drugs and alcohol at work. And number 10, take breaks appropriately.